So I'm going to, in this unit, look at a field example in which we'll be applying statistical techniques for problems of important significance in stock trading. So here is a stock price for a specific day in 2010. And the company we're discussing is Apple, which on that day started trading just above $250. But in the afternoon, the stock went all of a sudden down to $200, back to the original price. As a statistician, we are concerned about this. Because if you make trading decisions based on what's happening, we might lose millions or billions of dollars. This is a one-in-a-decade abnormal behavior. And as a statistician, we might care about writing software that finds these kind of behaviors so we stop trading and we don't fall into the trap of selling our stock at an unfortunate rate just because something really, really strange is happening. And that's a real example in which people lost millions, if not billions, of dollars. So on a typical trading day, Apple stock traded about 70,000 times, giving us 70,000 data points of prices during the day. What we'll be looking at is the percentage change between adjacent trades, which we call delta T. And that's defined as the difference between two consecutive trading points, XT plus 1 minus XT, normalized by XT. So normally, if XT and XT plus 1 is the same, this would be 0. If there's a big difference, then this is a larger value. And we know for the day in question what the mean and the standard deviation is for this percentage change. The mean is as small as 0.00074 negative in percent. So we leave off the percent is even 100 times smaller. And this is the value for the standard deviation, 0.01344%. My first question for you is to compute the confidence interval, assuming that we can use a confidence interval to detect outliers in the data. If you assume a symmetrical confidence interval with 5% confidence, then our magic factor, the percentile, is 1.96. Compute for me in percent the confidence interval for the variable delta t.